Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is George Aguilar, and today we're gonna test out two memories. I just got this Almaz memory, which is 64 gigabytes. It's a class 10 U1 rated as micro SD card, and we're gonna compare it to a Samsung 32 gigabyte class 10 U1 specified also. So they are very similar cards, and we're gonna check out what speed they read from. Is the Almaz good, or is it almost good, or is it just really, really bad against a name brand micro SD card? So right now we have Crystal Mark SD software, which we're gonna do the test on. So first off, we're gonna start off with the Almaz. We're gonna check out what the read and write speed is. We are gonna use the same adapter for both of these. We're gonna insert it directly to the laptop. We got that in. And we are gonna wait for it to detect it. It says it's the F. I'm gonna close this up, turn again, and should be right here, F, here we go. And we are gonna do a test, one pass, 50 megabytes, so it doesn't take as long. And we have just hit start. So like I said, this is a test of the Almaz micro SD card versus the Samsung Evo SD card. Both are same specification readings. We can see it has a read of 73.12 megabytes, but we're just gonna wait for this to finish. Let's hope it's comparable to the Samsung, something similar or not. Just to see if it's worth buying the Almaz micro SD card or not. Remember, Samsung is a highly recommended name brand, so it's gonna be a hard competition. Okay, it has finished doing the read speeds. And now we are gonna do the write megabytes per second. Now, if you guys want to know, you should know about specifications, cards that are class 10, U1, there's also U3. The U1s that we are testing right now are good for filmmaking up to 4K video at 50 megabytes per second. If we are shooting 4K at 100 megabytes per second, these cards are not going to do it. You will need a U3 specification micro SD card. That's just a quick info you guys need to know. If you guys are planning to shoot 4K at the highest quality of 100 megabytes per second, you will need U3 cards. Okay, and this is almost done. Okay, it's finishing up right now. Okay, so we got our read speed of 73.12 and a write speed of 37.41. Okay, let's remember those numbers. If you guys forget, you can turn the video back, or I'm gonna write it in the description. Okay, so now I'm gonna remove the Almaz micro SD card and I'm gonna insert the Samsung SD card. Let's get this in. I'm gonna close the Crystal Mark again. Remember 73 and 37. I'm gonna wait for it to read. Open this up. And here we go. We got that in. We're gonna do 50 megabytes. Start. Remember, 73 and 37. And we have started now with the Samsung SD card. Remember, it's also class 10 U1 specification micro SD card rating. Whoa, so this was actually really lower against the Almaz. Remember we had 73, and now we have 40 on read. Let's see if write speed, there's also a big difference or not. We do get a higher read speed when it's trying to do 4K. We had these on the number twos. Okay, these are doing better. When we're talking all around read speed, this is lower, but when we go 4K, it's higher. Now these, what does the read mean? For example, if we had something stored on the SD card and we wanted to read what's in it, with these, this would be much faster. And write speed would be when we take a picture or we're shooting video, that's when the SD card has to do writing. So that's also really important. Over here, well, that is really, really low. So basically the IOMOS is better in that sense. In a general sense, it's way higher. 73 against 37 that we had in the IOMOS, and right here we have 40 to 11. Let's see, let's have it finished. It's almost done. But yeah, basically I do recommend the IOMOS generic micro SD card. It's not a big name brand, but as you can see right here, it does work just like it should. It works even better than a good name brand. It's Samsung name brand. So it is recommended. It's almost done. Well, here are the numbers. Like I said, I'm gonna leave these numbers in the description against each other, so you guys, you might want to turn the video back or just check out the description to see how these cards did. All right, guys, so like I said, we are finishing up right here. Get this out. So it was the Evo against the IOMOS. The IOMOS did really, really well. So I do recommend it. If you guys want to buy one of these, I'm going to leave the link in the description just in case you guys want to buy one. Thanks for watching this video. I hope that it helped out. A really quick comparison with 50 megabytes read and write. So you guys could check out what the difference is, if it was worth it or not. And basically, it is worth buying. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you guys later.